The Golden State Warriors have had quite an interesting season so far. They started out as one of the hottest teams in the NBA, even with one of their best players on the team, Klay Thompson, still out with an injury. But then they fell into a slump, one that saw Curry shooting so poorly it made everyone wonder what was going on. But then Klay came back, the team bounced back, and at the time of this video, they're on a 9-game winning streak. But it takes more than stars to make a team, so allow us to show you why Otto Porter Jr. is so good for the Warriors. Otto Porter Jr. It is often said that availability is a player's best ability, a statement that applies heavily to someone like Otto Porter Jr. Porter played 80 games during the 2016-17 season, which was followed by 77 games in the 2017-18 season, both of which, to this day, remain his most and second most played games during the regular season, respectively. It is of no coincidence that both seasons happen to be the best statistical seasons of his career. In 2016-17, he averaged 13.4 points, 6.4 rebounds, and 1.5 assists on 52-43-83 shooting splits and 62.8% true shooting. That was followed up by an equally impressive 2017-18 campaign, 14.7 points, 5.1 rebounds, and 2.0 assists on 50-44-83 shooting splits and a 60.2% true shooting. In short, when Porter was at his absolute peak, both in skill and in well-being, the man was a walking 50-40-80 basketball machine. But a gander at his games played during subsequent seasons, however, paints the picture of a career that is seemingly headed towards its nadir, not long after reaching a promising peak. In the three seasons that followed 2017-18, Porter's games played count were as follows: 56-14-28. Those coincided with Porter accumulating various kinds of lower leg injuries, foot injuries, hip injuries, and, arguably the most debilitating of all, lower back injuries that hampered his mobility on both ends of the floor. A quick stat search over the past three seasons shows that Porter's combined numbers over that period didn't undergo a significant decline. He still averaged over 12 points a game on shooting splits of 45, 40, and 80. His scoring efficiency went down by a slight amount, 56.3% true shooting. But the main concern continued to be health. Even if his numbers on paper didn't precipitously fall, what use were such metrics if he could only muster a combined 98 games over three seasons? Such a series of unfortunate events obstructed Porter from a trajectory approaching that of a high-level role player or even a fringe all-star talent. Which is probably how the Golden State Warriors were able to obtain Porter using a veteran's minimum slot. A gamble that could either go extremely well for both him and the Warriors should he even approach the form he displayed five seasons ago. Or it could come back to haunt the team, especially if Porter's injury woes persist. The Warriors' hopes to contend in a highly competitive Western Conference certainly won't be made or broken solely by Porter. But the depth he provides as a 3-and-D specialist off the bench is a mouthwatering prospect that would make the former a more palatable situation than the latter. Certain set of skills. Porter is a knockdown shooter who would immensely improve the spacing of a team that did not have the requisite floor-stretching personnel to surround its talismanic superstar. He is a career 40.3% shooter, which would slot him beside Stephen Curry and Klay Thompson as the only players on the current roster to average at least 40% on threes for their careers. Unlike Curry and Thompson, however, Porter is not a high-volume sharpshooter, averaging only 3.3 three-point attempts per game throughout his career. The logical thought progression upon seeing Porter's low-volume shooting nature would be to think of him as a purely catch-and-shoot and spot-up operator, a mostly correct assertion. In 2020-21, 90.4% of Porter's threes were of the catch-and-shoot variety, or 3.4 catch-and-shoot attempts per game. He had a success rate of 41.4% on such shots. Porter plies his trade effectively as a stationary kickout target. Possessions that bend and stretch defenses to their rotational limits, such as dribble penetration and short roll playmaking possessions, accentuate his talent as a sniper. Synergy ranked Porter highly in terms of spot-up possessions last season, 1.192 points per possession, PPP. Take note, however, that this was on a low volume of shots, with only 70 spot-up shot attempts being recorded in 25 games with the Chicago Bulls. Go back a few seasons to 2016-17, and on a more representative sample of 292 spot-up attempts, Porter scored 1.310 PPP, 97th percentile. He maintained that excellence the following season, 1.154 PPP on 255 attempts, placing him in the 85th percentile. Proficient shooting must also involve the mobility factor, generating chaos and gravity by running around screens, catching the ball, and maintaining or regaining one's balance are ingredients that are crucial to the makeup of a dead-eye marksman. Porter's no different. He slithers around staggered down screens and has no problems drilling a shot, even with a form that looks slightly askew midair. He makes good use of off-ball aids such as flare screens to free himself up for looks, especially against defenders dropping too far back to switch or contest. On occasion, he's a willing screener, either as part of a double drag alignment or as a solitary ghost screener, often popping up toward unguarded space and creating an open look. Defenses already have to worry about Curry and Thompson running around screens and creating all sorts of organized chaos. Porter being there to act as another weapon on secondary slash weak side actions isn't going to make their jobs any easier. Excelling. Porter excels as a shooter from any point of the floor. Historically, he is an effective above-the-break shooter, peaking at an incredible 100th percentile in 2016-17 and 2017-18 per cleaning the glass. Even with limited minutes and appearances last season, he still posted a respectable 38% on above-the-break threes, 63rd percentile. Curry and Thompson are both masters at stopping short of the arc in transition and pulling up for threes. Add Porter and Nemanja Bjelica, themselves deadly above-the-break shooters in transition, and it could stretch transition defenses to their limits. Last season was Porter's career high in terms of corner three percentage, burying 47% of his attempts and placing him in the 84th percentile. He can park himself on the corners with a shrewd pick-and-roll operator handling the ball, and he will punish low-man help and roll-man tags while also being capable of sprinting to corners in transition. As an off-ball schematic defender, Porter can hold his own. He is a decent help defender, displaying flashes of effectiveness as the low man on the weak side. He steps up to downhill attackers and can contest shots effectively or even outright block them. He can recover fairly well to his man after tagging rollers, using his length to bother shots, and close out effectively. He is rarely caught ball watching, and that's good. But injuries. So far, Porter has missed 7 games this season, and he might miss 2 this week, depending on how things go. In 43 games, Porter Jr. is averaging 8.7 points on 48% shooting from the field, with 5.3 rebounds and 1.6 assists in 21.9 minutes per game. With Draymond Green missing time due to injury, Porter Jr. has started the last 5 games for the Warriors. Granted, even if they were to lose these next few games, they're still the definitive number 2 seed in the Western Conference right now. What's more, the All-Star break is almost here, so that'll give players like Klay, Draymond, and Porter the chance to rest for a good while before needing to suit up for the final games of the season. Bringing all you can. We've listed out a lot of stats for you on Porter Jr. based on both last season and this one. And the reason for this is that right now, the Warriors have the ability to really go for a title. The first time since their dynasty dissolved in a sea of injuries via Klay, Kevin Durant, and then Curry. But now, with support players like Porter Jr., as well as getting most of the squad back that they need, they're pushing hard for the title. They need everyone at 100% or as close to it to handle certain teams in the West and the East. It's unknown how Otto Porter Jr. will perform in the playoffs, but if he's even just a little helpful, that might just be what the Warriors need to get to the top once again. So, what do you think? What do you think of this look at Otto Porter Jr. as well as the Golden State Warriors as a whole? Do you think that when they are back to 100% with Otto, Draymond, and the rest, that they'll be pretty much unstoppable in the playoffs? What do you feel is the most reasonable expectations for this team right now? Let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you next time on the channel.